For the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, from the capital city of the United States of America, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
What's up, y'all? This is Relly, y'all, back with another video. Yes, and today we have to talk about the trade rumors regarding the Cleveland Cavaliers. But before we get into that, I need y'all to smash that subscribe button. And if you already subscribed to my channel, I need y'all to share it to somebody who ain't subscribed, because we are still on that grinding with y'all. I know I can get there. And when y'all are done with that, I need y'all to hover over to that like button, smash that too, so we can tell the YouTube algorithm to share this video with the world. But with all that being said, we gotta talk about the trade rumors regarding the Cleveland Cavaliers. And of course, I gotta plug myself in, because why not? You get what I'm saying? But if y'all got some free time and y'all feel like y'all want to show me some love, man, click the link down in the description box below or in the comment section if I have it there. And just give me a follow, man. This is where I'm gonna have a lot of the news and updates regarding my channel, so y'all can stay up to date. And if y'all have any questions or just suggestions, y'all can message me on this account. But like I said before, we gotta talk about the first trade rumors regarding the Cavs, and that's Kevin Knox, right? I think these trade rumors right here probably is the most realistic out of all the trade rumors we're gonna talk about, because Kevin Knox was floating around the Cleveland Cavaliers since the trade deadline and before the trade deadline, right? It was rumored that the Cleveland Cavaliers was having some thoughts about getting Kevin Knox, because they felt like he was a player they could develop on the Cleveland Cavaliers, right? Yes, I know a lot of people might see that Kevin Knox averaged around 4 points, 2 rebounds, I think. I'm going to have it in the video too, so, you know, tell me if I'm wrong. But Kevin Knox was a player that needed a lot of work, right? And I feel like the Cleveland Cavaliers can give him a chance. Now, like I said before, I know a lot of Cleveland fans might not be liking that, because they just don't see the potential in them, and I can understand why. But for the Cleveland Cavaliers organization, they feel like they can get out that gem inside of him. Now, the biggest negative on Kevin Knox, which honestly is my biggest concern about him, is how much money does he think he's worth in this modern NBA? You get what I'm saying? Because you got to understand, he is a restricted free agent, and his contract year is next year, right? Now, understand, like we talk about this a lot on this channel, restricted free agents typically stay on the team that has them, right? And if the Cleveland Cavaliers have them, that means he stays with us. But the caveat is, how much does Kevin Knox think he's worth on the free agent market, right? And based off how a lot of these contracts goes, and my friend nailed it on the head, right? A lot of these players get paid off of potential, not based off of what they actually do. And that kind of scares me, because will we overly pay for Kevin Knox? You get what I'm saying? Like, now, I'm not saying he's going to get no $200 million. I would hope not. But I'm just scared. Like, I don't feel like anything above $40 million would be worth what he brings to the table as of right now, right? Like, I'm not giving you $40, $60, $70 million when you average 4 points. You get what I'm saying? And I feel like this is something the Cleveland Cavaliers is going to have to think about if we make this trade and decide we're going to extend him long term. And of course, we got to talk about the trade rumors of the Cleveland Cavaliers trying to pursue Brandon Ingram as well as Jaylen Brown. Now, me personally, these two names, if the trade rumors are legit, I think we need to get one of the two players, right? Like, honestly, I think Jaylen Brown is probably going to be untouchable for Boston. I don't see no reason why they would trade Jaylen Brown when they realize they needed Jaylen Brown to possibly get past the next round. Now, I'm not saying they would have beat Brooklyn, but they would have been a lot more competitive if Jaylen Brown was on the floor, and it's no rocket science to that. Now, Brandon Ingram, that's going to be kind of interesting, because Brandon Ingram also has a case to say, hey, he's a very essential part to the development of the Pelicans, but if you can get the right three team in there, probably throwing the right amount of picks, right assets, David Griffin might be willing to consider that, right? Not saying he has to, because neither one of these teams have to make that trade, especially not Boston. But this is something we could try to get into, right? And if we are trying to get into it, I think Jaylen Brown would be ideal, but I think Brandon Ingram would be the most realistic if one of these two trades were to happen. And of course, I have to talk about the trade rumors of the Cleveland Cavaliers being interested in trying to get Alex Caruso or TJ McConnell, right? And I feel like the Cleveland Cavalier fans is so excited for these two individual point guards or guards, however you want to place them, because they just like what they bring and possibly bring to the Cleveland Cavaliers, right? Because yes, they're not going to be superstars for by any means, but those intangibles that you have to see watching the game is what they bring. Like TJ McConnell, he brings energy. He makes, like when you see him, he makes you feel like he truly wants to be on your roster, right? Alex Caruso the same way. Like he's not a superstar, but the vibe he gives across as a team is superstar-ish, right? And I know that that's probably weird to say, but it's just certain, like Lance Stephenson is a great example, right? He was never a superstar, but just how he played the game, right? His energy on the floor just made him so likable, right? And it's the same thing with like Anderson Virgil and other players, Big Z. You know what I'm saying? Players that is just fan favorites around the league. Like people just gravitated to him because of that energy. Jamal Crawford would be another great example, right? And the Cleveland Cavaliers want to get a hold of one of those guards because I feel like TJ McConnell would be great for his veteran leadership alongside either Colin Sexton or Darius Garland. And Alex Caruso too, because now he has the veteran pedigree, right? He got a championship. He understands what he got to do to play alongside any other guard. He's played point guard. He's played off guard. He knows what he has to do. He knows what he's talking about. And I think that type of experience is what our guards need right now. And I feel like a lot of Cleveland fans understands that too, which is why we are so excited for these trade rumors. Now, I'm not going to lie. I did have the intentions of making a separate video about this, and I might still do it, but I was thinking about this so much because a lot of people have been asking me, how do I feel about this? And honestly, I feel like this is the most appropriate statement in terms of rumors, because let's be real, since we drafted Colin Sexton, it was going to be 4 to 5 years plus before we really see how the team developed, right? Because yes, it would be beautiful for us to draft a talent that is showing glimpses and is a superstar, but realistically that is not what happens all the time. Yes, a superstar happens to be in the making in a draft, right? You know, you got Dons, you got the LeBrons, you got the Kyries, you got the Joel Embiid, you know, you got those type of players in there, right? You got to find them, right? But for us, the Cleveland Cavaliers, we just have to work so much harder, right? And Colin Sexton, he's a good piece. Darius Garland is a good piece. But we still got to give him time to really grow into himself. Because let's be real, Colin Sexton, this is his third year. Darius Garland, this is his second year. Isaac Okoro, this was his first year. Jared Allen, this is his fourth year in the NBA, right? Like, you cannot expect talent 4 years in the league to already be on some Luka Doncic tier. You get what I'm saying, right? Like, every player is not going to be Luka. Every player is not going to be Don. Every player is not going to be Ja Morant. Every player is not going to be LaMelo Ball. And because they're not all going to be those players, you got to give them time to fill those shoes to be a Luka Doncic, a John Moran, a LaMelo Ball. You get what I'm saying? And I think for the Cleveland Cavaliers, we have to be extra patient because we already have the reputation of not being patient and just let the talent grow. Now, obviously, it is talent on the team that obviously has to be moved, like Kevin Love. You get what I'm saying? Just like last year, I said Tristan Thompson, we cannot re-sign him. We got to, you know, thank him for what he did, but let him move on, right? And we did that. But we have to keep that going in order to get our young guys more confident and better. And for more amazing content, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you can be a part of the grind. And with that being said, go. Hey,
hey, motivated all about cash flow, ran it up and ran out of excuses. In the field and we turn into hoops. Freddy clip like bonds we show. Jedi some soldiers we troopin'. Step back 3, we hoopin'. We on house just like Fortnite.